Welcome everybody to my top 10 best sci-fi anime. My name is Misty slash Phoenix here, and when it comes to anime, I'm the best tool you can have. I'm like a winch in oil. I mean wrench in oil.
Why oil?
Well, oil is supposed to help in making it, right? I mean, I don't know about cars, bro, but I just put gas in it and it goes vroom vroom, so
God, I fucking hate you sometimes.
But hey, now that it's been taken care of, you guys want to talk about anime? I mean, anime? I swear, I know my stuff. Don't you go yet, I promise I'll be good. Anyhow, you know the usual drill, this top 10 serves to present to you new anime in the light of this topic, being sci-fi. Now, there's a lot of sci-fi anime out there, so I'm telling you right now, you already stopped listening, huh? There's not going to be any space-related sci-fi. I know when you say sci-fi, usually it involves space, but no, I'm going to do an extra one special about stars and space and all the cool jazz and galaxy stuff. But now, I'm gonna stay right down on Earth, and we're gonna enjoy this sci-fi show together. So, you don't have a problem with that? Good. Have I told you how I love you today? Feels like I don't mention it often enough. Number 10, Buddy Complex. Look at the colors and character design. Isn't that just enough to get you super horny into watching this anime? This show is brand new from spring 2014. It has a giant 13-episode span, and it's about mechas. Now, I know normally sci-fi rings mechas, this is the only anime that I'm gonna be focused with this in the list. I already have a top 10 mecha, so I want to keep things interesting. The story of Buddy Complex is about a high schooler getting into driving his own robot. If that makes you rock hard, then Godspeed, my friend.
Deal!
Number 9, Saint Seiya. And now a little kickback from the past. Saint Seiya came out in the mid 80s, but I like to think it's one of the pioneer of anime alongside Sailor Moon and Dragon Ball. This show has been spread with a giant load of maple syrup. I mean, it's got over 200 episodes, all scattered through several sequels and spin-offs. While you may find the art style particular, if you give it a few episodes, you'll forget all about it, and it's really worth it. Number 8, A Certain Scientific Railgun. Okay, so this show's a bit tricky. This is one of them show where it's all tangled together with another series. Same character, same story, just different timestamp. The other show you should have in consideration is A Certain Magical Index. The order they came is Index 1, Railgun 1, Index Season 2, Railgun Season 2. Though the storyline chronologically is Railgun 1, Index 1, Railgun 2, Index 2. It's confusing, but you know, you'll get it. It's really not a big deal anyway. Number 7, Black Bullet. Yet another early spring 2014 release. Again with the 13 episode format, this time around Black Bullet follows the life of a young boy living in a small territory in fear of giant parasite. So a little down the road he gets recruited by the government, so his partner and him will have to go on a secret mission to prevent the destruction of Tokyo. It's a very fun show with loads of colors, set in the near future ambience, and gets you hooked really early on.
わらわのプロポーズに対するお返事はどうした?プロポーズ?
Number Number 6, Kaiba. Okay, so if you want something trippy, fresh, new, with an art style that's different from the typical Big Eyes character, this might actually intrigue you. Yes, despite its art style, it's still an anime. The story of this show reminds me a little of the premise of Serial Experiment Lane. The anime got released in 2008 and lasts for 12 episodes, and as far as sci-fi goes, it doesn't get any sci-fi-er. That's not a word. But you ain't the dictionary police, so get off my back, Kai.
She's artificial too, are you? Don't be rude, it's obvious that she's...
She is nothing more than a doll named Hede. A poor puppet who still lives, even though her soul has been taken away from her.
Number 5, Genkutsuo, The Count of Monte Cristo. Just like number 6, this anime shined by its original art style. This is yet another uncommon canvas. This anime brings back the story written by Alexandre Dumas, one of the classics turned into an anime. Of course, this adaptation is loosely based on its original work, but you need to check it out nonetheless. This anime came out between 2004 and 2005 and is a whole 24 episodes. And despite being based on the 19th century, there are still loads of sci-fi to take place in this, so look for the first episode and give it a shot.
Listen, the Count just isn't as cold a man as many people think he is. Isn't that right, sir?
Number 4, Denno Coil. This is one of the best shows you'll see in a long, long time. The story sets in a near future, 2026, where genius children are in charge of an investigation. This is a really poorly known anime that may appear childish on the surface, but truly deserves this spot, if not higher on this list. It came out in 2007, with 26 episodes on chart, and it is an amazing depiction of what the future holds with the augmented reality eyeglass and all the cool gadgets you can think of. If you're a sucker for intellectual anime, this is a really pleasing one. Number 3, Trigun. Trigun is a show that I have long wished to include in my top 10, but it never seemed to be fitting in the genre I was choosing, so I kept holding it back because I didn't want to give it a poor rank. So while the sci-fi aspect may not be overflowing within this anime, it is one I immensely recommend for its action, its comedy, and its characters. This series has 26 episodes who came out in 1998, so it's a bit dated, yet it is a legendary classic.
That was a pretty close one. Almost bought the farm back there. It's actually a miracle that I got away with it this time.
I found him! Over there!
Perfect shot!
<笑>私の偽らざる気持ちです。でもサキは私たちとは違う。前にも言いましたが、あなたはとても強い人です。
Number 2, Shinsekai Yori. What a piece of work this show is. This anime, 25 episodes long, came out in 2012, 2013, and touched a lot of genre. Drama, horror, sci-fi, supernatural, so I'm blogging it in sci-fi. Now, if you got a problem with that, you can talk to my agent, but joke's on you, I don't have one. I'm so lonely. Anyway, so the story is about a millennium from now, a girl living in a happy place gets some psychic powers and she has to attend to a school to train with other kids, but the children get abducted. It's really good. Number 1, Eve no Jikan. This is not even a TV anime. This came out on the web with only 6 episodes. Normally in my list I tend to stick to TV show only, but not this time. This bad boy is such an emotional tale. If you like robots, this is gonna move you. Like, from San Francisco to Philadelphia. It has endearing characters, spectacular art style that is gonna kick you in the face with its high heel hooker boots. I am not kidding, the lighting is hotter than a girl wearing pigtails in summer. Wow, this is getting kinky. Point is, you better check it out! So So that's some pretty sexy anime I just gave you right there. Don't you go and abuse of them in the dark alley. If it's in broad daylight, it might pass easier, but late at night, it just makes me uncomfortable, man. So while you guys are busy making out with these entries, I'll focus on my main issue. Now, the pianos have their theme song, Moonlight Sonata, which is a giant bummer because every time it plays, it paralyzes our troops and poisons their blood. Since my faithful Yuta viewers, Twin's Army has grown so incredibly much, even over 100,000 subscribers, I've thought it'd be a great idea to get ourselves a counter theme song. So I got this awesome radio right here. I'm gonna try and fiddle and get something good out of it. Hey Misty, you've been all around all night, and that's a little long. You think you've got the right, but I think you've got it wrong. Why can't you say goodnight so you can take me home, Misty?
Nope.
Your stare was holding, ripped jeans, skin was showing, hot night wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, Misty? Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me Misty.
Nuh-uh.
And all the Misty says, I'm pretty fly for a white guy.
Nope.
As he came through the window, was the sound of a crescendo. He came to her apartment, left the bloodstains on the carpet. So she ran under the table, you could see she wasn't able. So she ran into the bedroom, she was struck down, it was her due. Misty, you're okay, so Misty, are you okay? Are you okay, Misty? Misty, you're okay, so Misty, are you okay? Are you okay, Misty? Misty, you're okay, so Misty, are you okay? Are you okay, Misty? Misty, are you okay, so Misty, are you okay? Are you okay, Misty? Misty, are you okay? Would you tell us that you're okay? Duh.
Chronexia, come in lampo di vita, chronexia, come in passo gridar, chronexia, del delituoso grido, per urgente pena seren, come la rabbia di amar, chronexia. Come in assalto di gioia.
God, these are just awful. Instead, I'm just gonna leave you with this.
Hey guys, just a quick word to thank you all so very much for subscribing during all this time. This channel has been up for like 2 or 3 months, and I've recently, maybe like last week, because, well, between last top 10 and this one, I just broke 100,000 subscribers, and that is freaking amazing. I cannot thank you all so very much enough. It's blowing my mind. I am not realizing how many people that is that just follows my stuff every time I put something new, and I cannot, as I said, thank you enough for that. It's the greatest support you could show me. And just, if you're not even subscribed, I thank you for spending this time to tag along and watch my video. So I hope you will all continue to follow me as I put new stuff. There's going to be a lot of more top 10s coming up, and there's review that I'm planning to do, but since I also juggle with my real day life job that I have, 40 hours plus the 40 hours extra I put on YouTube, it adds up a lot. So at the end of the week, I do 80 hours, so it's kind of hard for me to put more than I actually do. However, I really love doing this job. YouTube is all my life now. It's all I talk about, pretty much. And it's just so much fun. So I do plan on continuing this very, well, for a very long time. So I will see you guys on the next video. There will be more Katawa Shoujo Let's Play that I'm doing. There will be more backseat anime watching. There will be reviews at some point. It's just a whole bunch of stuff that I'm planning on doing if I can manage the time. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you around. Take care.